How do I fix a lazy eye and eyelid? I was in an accident when I was 10 that caused me to have a retinal detachment. I have very little vision in my right eye, and over the years, it's starting to droop and wander a little. I had eyelid surgery a couple years ago that worked for a short period, but eventually went back to the way it was. I'm very insecure about it, and I use eye drops to make it lift my eyelid. I know this is terrible, but it's the only thing that works. I just want to have a normal eye. Please help.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a photo and you describe your frustration with one eyelid being lower, relatively speaking, than the other. And you state that you had a retinal detachment after an accident in the right eye and that you did have eyelid surgery that worked to elevate the eye. That did work for a short time, but then has the eyelid regressed. You also describe how you use an eye drop to cause your eyelid to lift up so that you get more symmetry. Well, I can certainly give you a perspective on how I would evaluate you. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I have been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and the complexities of having undergone retinal detachment surgery is certainly a part of the challenge of your situation. What you are doing, which is effective, is that you're using an eye drop to stimulate a muscle called Mueller's muscle, and that muscle is what contracts. There are two muscles that lift the eyelid. One is the levator muscle and one is called Mueller's muscle. And Mueller's muscle, when it contracts, it does elevate the eyelid. Now, the challenge in your situation also has to do with the relative size of your eye. The typical situation, and although it's a little bit difficult, but I get the feeling that the right eye is smaller, eyeball speaking, in terms of the eyeball itself, is smaller compared to the left eye. Now, that's not unusual after retinal detachment surgery, and especially when it's clear that you don't have good vision out of that eye, hence the reason why it drifts. I would say that that poses an additional challenge because the dynamics of the way the levator muscle interacts with the eye has to all, the relative prominence of the eye has a certain factor in the physics of the way the muscle is able to lift the eye. Now, if someone looks at you I'm just speaking now not as a professional, but let's say just through the eyes of a layperson, I would say that the difference between your two eyes are not as bad as you probably perceive. And the reason I say this is that it's normal within the normal population to have about a 1 to 2 millimeter difference between the two eyes. So what may have become a fixation for you, to the rest of the world and for anyone else, a casual observer, is not that obvious. It could be that actually the prominence of the eye in terms of the size may be also a contributing factor which is more contributing to the perception of the difference. Now, that being said, your options are relatively straightforward. You can consider having another eyelid operation. And of course, the challenge is whether or not it will succeed. Because during surgery, when we do like Ptosis surgery, I'll have the patient sit up during surgery. I'll make sure that the eyes are even and symmetric and look good. But even with that, a certain percentage of time, the patients will the eyelid will drop, and there's a variety of reasons. It could be how the stitch held. It could be how the muscle quality, the tissue quality, the muscle. It can be just from eye rubbing and from pressure on the eye. There can be a lot of different factors. So understanding the context of how it affects your overall appearance is important when you make these decisions. You know, Ptosis surgery can be a fantastic operation, but when you have other complicating factors, it does make it more of a challenge. And when you're dealing with these other variables, and in terms of having a reoperation, you know, there's scar tissue, there's other things that make it more difficult to do the operation. Very often, when I see a patient who's had multiple surgeries, I realize that it's not necessarily the previous surgeons who did anything technically wrong, but it could be just how well the tissue holds and how well it heals. You know, once the eyelid heals, there's still blinking, and the pressure of the downward movement of the eyelid, it can cause various levels of stretching or dehiscence. So I certainly understand your frustration. But that being said, you may want to discuss this with friends and family and have them look at different pictures of you from different angles before you put the drops in, and just look at you in person and say what they feel before you pursue more surgery. But that's just my impression just looking at the photo. Now, if the photo is the result of you putting drops in, well, then in that case, then you probably do have a more significant ptosis, which certainly does deserve some type of attention. But it could be it can be some variation of a ptosis surgery, but in the end, it is going to have to require surgical intervention. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.